In this prayer, I'm going to ask you to plant your emptiness. Now, that's a different concept. Years ago, I mean decades ago, I went to a very wise woman, a minister, and I said to her, I feel empty. I just don't know that I have it in me to give anymore. And she was working with her plants in her greenhouse. She didn't even turn around. She was putting seeds in the soil. And she said, plant your emptiness. God loves to fill emptiness in a life. And I'm asking you in prayer right now to do that. If there's any area of your life that feels empty, that feels incomplete, that feels unsatisfied, to plant it now in God. God grant that Christ may dwell in your heart by faith, that you may be filled with the fullness of God. Ephesians 3, 16 through 19. May you right now in this prayer plant your emptiness. May you right now in this prayer be filled with the fullness of God. May you know in this prayer that God absolutely delights in turning emptiness into fullness, and that God stands ready right now to take your impossibilities of your human situation, to fill it and to turn it into life-giving joy. You consent right now to releasing your emptiness, not holding on to it, not allowing your emptiness to define you. You approach God in prayer with your emptiness, your impossibilities, and as being in the greenhouse of your life, you plant that in the soil of God-given new life. You plant all your human impossibilities right down into the heart of God's resourcefulness. And you leave it there. And you know in faith right now that God is working. Your willingness has been planted. Your emptiness has been planted. You're saying to God through this action, God, take this. Make something of this. And in faith, it is growing. God's fullness will cause your life to come alive. We pray that our lives will come alive. We pray that our emptiness will be transformed into a fullness of new life, restored life. We pray that our impossibilities will become life-giving possibilities. We know that the rewards of faith and the realization of hope is in this prayer. And in this prayer, we now say yes to God. In Ephesians 3, verse 20, it promises, "Now unto them that are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that they think or ask, according to the power that worketh in them." I pray that a power is working in you. I pray that a new power is working in your emptiness. I pray that a new power is working in every impossibility in your life. I pray it's God's power. I pray that all of the emptiness and the impossibilities are planted in God and planted in the action of pure faith on the part of me, on the part of you. And we watch it grow into something that cannot die, into something that will live on even beyond us. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen.